So guys, this is a short video about the altcoins, alternative cryptocurrencies, and which ones, in my opinion, are worth taking a bet, are worth investing in at the current valuations. We have the first one up is Ethereum. Ethereum market cap is currently $700 million. I think it is relatively pricey compared to other altcoins. In the end, it is great technology. It has strong leadership. It has a business model, though the business model is not that great. So they don't have issuance of coins for to pay people. They don't have that. I was wrong in that in the past. They did have issued capital, $18 million, but they burned all that. However, thanks to they did also issue coins, but only at inception to the foundation, and those coins have gone up a lot in value, and so they do have funding, but it's limited in time. But I think that Ethereum has really made the best case the past 3 years, since the last bubble of Bitcoin. A lot of new altcoins have come onto market, and Ethereum was the most successful in capturing the imagination of developers and attracting venture capital, creating hype, I think for Ethereum the odds are very good to actually go up a lot in value in the next Bitcoin bubble. So I think that's a very good investment to diversify some Bitcoins into at this stage. I would not buy them at market. I would put in buy orders. Currently, it's about... it has broken the all-time low. And so I think it's about 100,000 Satoshi. Is that correct? No, 1 million Satoshi, yeah. So, but it has gone to 2 million... 3 million Satoshi. So that was the peak, but 500,000 Satoshi was its first plateau after the in the bubble. So I think you will have your odds are very good to buy between 500,000 Satoshi and 1 million Satoshi. So if you put buy walls in that range, I think you have a good chance to see that filled up. But of course, if you decide to invest in Ethereum, you have to buy some already at current prices, because there is always a small chance that it doesn't happen, and then you don't have any if you just put up buy walls. But I would say 30% by now, but leave 60% to be filled in buy walls that are considerably lower, like 50% lower than the current price. 30% lower. So the next one up is Litecoin. Ripple. I have never, it has never clicked for me, Ripple. There are innovations there, but it's not, I don't think it's interesting, because it's the issuance is very important of the amount of coins, and they have issued a lot of coins. Most of that are in the hands of the company, but this gives me like not enough security that this will be a limited supply coin. Then Litecoin, I think, is to be avoided. I think it's dangerous to invest in cryptocurrencies that have not innovated, because it is possible that these coins will die. Even though Litecoin, all altcoins have a very good chance to go up a lot versus Bitcoin, Litecoin included, it's just too risky for me. So I would not invest in that. Monero actually is interesting, because they have innovated and they offer a lot more privacy to end users, but they have their weaknesses too. They don't have a business model, eh? So they are fully dependent, like with Bitcoin, on donations to pay for development, and this causes slow development. They still don't have a user interface. This is not acceptable after after 3 years. But this is big. In Bitcoin, you see the same happening, that development is slow. So this business model where the developers are dependent on donations is not a good idea. But Monero has is the only one actually in the market that offers standard mixing of all coins. So when you send a transaction, it's always mixed or always like anonymized. And this is very important. Dash does not offer that. I thought they did, but they don't. Even Zcash, the new kid on the block, does not offer that. And so Monero has a very, very good chance to receive a lot of Bitcoin investments in the next bubble. Just Bitcoin is diversifying. They have heard about Monero the past 3 years. So it is something that's known. It's a brand that's known. And so I think it's a good investment. Ethereum Classic, in my opinion, is too risky. I don't think, it's just that I don't believe in copy coins, never have. So, but I've been very wrong. There is a lot of money to be made there too. But like Litecoin, when that was launched, yes, it has gone up a lot in value, but it was just, for the most part, a copy of Bitcoin, and without much innovations. And I think the same is true for Ethereum Classic. I understand that the immutability is very important for Bitcoin, but for Ethereum, I think there are a lot of other factors that are much more important, and I think you do need very strong leadership for any project to be successful. And so this utopia of decentralized leadership that does not exist, that does not exist, also not in Bitcoin. You either have a strong leader or a weak leader, or no leader. Well, no leader that doesn't exist, and it's a quorum. Eh? So in Bitcoin, it's like three or five developers that basically decide together. Eh? But that's the leader. They call the shots. Eh? And so there's always someone calling the shots everywhere. And so you will need that. You have that in Ethereum with Vitalik, and that's very good. And you had it in Bitcoin with Satoshi. He left. Then you had it with his follow-up guy. His name, you know the name, and then he gave that to three guys, and they do that together now. You always have strong leadership, and you will have that too in ETC, and it will all depend on that leadership. The future of this coin will all depend on that, and so. I think immutability is overrated in general, not for Bitcoin. That was instrumental and very important to keep, but the competitors will have to offer more user-friendly coins than Bitcoin, because for most people, the end consumers, it is not acceptable that when your money is stolen, the system says, yeah, sorry, your fault, too bad. No. So the coins that will grow a lot will have a solution for that. And so that's why I think that Ethereum will not lose that much potential due to reversing a theft. And so I think the risk is very high in Ethereum Classic. That's my personal opinion, and I've been wrong many times before, and I could certainly be wrong here. And so It's just my two cents. Dash is the next one. Dash is in a very interesting coin. They are not the first to offer a mixture of proof of work coin and then build also a proof of stake coin next to it. They have that by I don't know the name they have for it, but basically the way they vote on things. Oh no, they also have a system to mix your coins, but it's only on demand. And when you want to do that, you can do that. And they use some kind of a peer nodes for that. And you have to have 1,000 dash on each. And these you also need if you want to vote for grants. So they have, but what they have done as the first is to really have a sustainable business model. Where the issuance of new coins is not only for miners, but it's also for mixers, and 10% is also for the grant system, where anybody can propose to do something and get paid with that. So I think that's very innovative and very good. And I think Dash, therefore, is worth taking a bet on. Steam, for me, I don't understand the business model. I don't think it's sustainable. So I understand that people vote on stuff, and then you get Steam, and then you can cash out that Steam slowly over time. That's okay, but who's putting in the value? Why would an investor buy Steam? Because a lot of people get Steam, so they cash it out. So you have a downward pressure. But who's gonna buy all that Steam and have given upward pressure? I don't understand that. I don't see, like, why would I invest in Steam? I would only invest if I see the potential of the coin to go up in value, yes. But I would only do that if I know that other investors also want to buy that coin. But like, there is a huge inflation. All these people only cash out Steam. So I don't see it as a sustainable business model. I think there is a mistake there. For example, if they would have advertising revenue, and because it's a blog website, so okay, it attracts a lot of articles because you can get paid. Okay, so if it's successful, you could create source of income via, for example, advertising. If that income would be distributed to Steam holders, then you have a reason to hold on to Steam because it has a source of income. And so do you have a potential for the price to go up? That would be a closed system. I don't see that yet. Augur, I don't know enough to even comment on. I know it's a marketplace to put predictions on, but I haven't studied enough in depth to give any opinion on. I don't know. It's connected to Ethereum but I can't judge it. MageSafe coin, I think, has way too long been in development for 8 years or so, and so it's too risky of an investment. I think past performance is the best indicator of future performance. If people don't deliver in a timely manner, then you can't expect that to change in the future if they continue to do the same. I haven't studied MageSafe coin in depth. That's the only thing I know about it. That's what has kept me from investing, because it has been in development way too long and the ambitions are also too big. I have a totally decentralized internet. Like, that's just like, I've lost a lot of money in too ambitious goals. You have to take it step by step. NEM is actually started from the NXT community, but has gone their own way. And they have succeeded in going up a lot in value, much more than NXT. I would say I can't give an opinion on it because I'm too biased. So I will also leave that for other people. Waves, I think, is too risky. It is a market cap of 23 million, but their ambition is to have a decentralized asset exchange, but where you can trade the assets of Bitcoin. They also come from the NXT community, and I don't see again how that token, that Waves token, is going to become valuable if you can just trade on the decentralized asset exchange with Bitcoin. Why would you buy Waves, the token? I don't understand that. Dogecoin, though it is tempting to buy, at these valuations, 22 million, I think it is also too risky because it hasn't innovated. It doesn't have strong leadership anymore. The founder left. It has no business model. It's just based on donations. And also the amount of transactions is faked since the start. They had tremendous amount of transactions per day, and it has continued to go down the past 3 years. And the amount of transactions is so high that it just doesn't make any sense. It's just not true. It's not possible. But what they do have is brand, as the only coin other than Bitcoin that has a strong brand. And that means that a lot of people know about it. Everybody knows Dogecoin. But who knows Waves? Who knows NEM? Huh? Who knows Augur? Not many people know that. Steam, yeah, a little. But Dogecoin, like, even people that only know Bitcoin, well, some will know Dogecoin. That's the only thing that reached the news in 2013 and may reach the news again. And so may actually go up a lot in value, but it's not a, for me, it's just too risky. But I do understand, like, if somebody invests in it, I think they have a good chance to actually make money in the next Bitcoin bubble. A very good chance at this valuation. That's only gone down versus Bitcoin the past 2-3 years. Huh? DGX, DAO, I don't know. Stellar, Lumens, Dogecoin has valuation of 20 million. I just have to say something about cryptocurrencies. And that's very important also to realize that the amount of transactions in all these coins has not gone up. Like, there is, it's really very, very bad. Just from that perspective, there's not a single, to my knowledge, altcoin that has really found utility and also has grown in that. Like Clams, for example, has a unique utility. You need that to, if you want to gamble on Just Dice, you need Clams, okay. But the amount of transactions in Clams, to my knowledge, has not gone up the past year or 2 years. And you should see strong growth. You should see other people adopting that coin, and I miss that there. But at least it has unique utility. You really need it for something, and you can't do it with Bitcoin. That's something that's very hard to find. But even if you find it, you see that it's not really gaining traction. I don't see the amount of transactions going up, and I think there's a big problem in the world of altcoins. But as I said in a previous video, that's not always necessary. It's possible that first the price goes up, and only then the amount of transactions goes up. That's always been the case also in previous bubbles, that the amount of transactions of the altcoins was not going up, not for real utility, and so, but even then the price of the altcoins went up a lot. So I don't think it's like a reason enough to not invest in altcoins, but it means that Bitcoin should be respected and should have a decent position in any cryptocurrency portfolio, because that's the only coin that's going up and has continued to go up in amount of transactions. And even if it's like tops out right now because of technical limitations, well, that's a great problem to have if you're not like being able to follow demand as a development team. That's really poor performance on your part, but it's a great problem to have. There are no altcoins that have that problem. Stellar, Lumens, I don't know to judge. Factum, I don't know to judge. Peerplace, I don't know. Economy is 15 million. I recommend to stay away. This is a project done by James, and I think he has proven in the past to not deliver. He has launched a lot of ICOs, and he has not delivered his promises. So I think that's too risky. Even though he may change, he may deliver this time. He has delivered some things, but it was really not enough to create a long-term, sustainable, successful coin or cryptocurrency project or company. And so that's why I think it's too risky to invest in. Lisk is also coming from the NXT community at 15 million market cap. But I don't know enough to judge it. But I do know it's coming from Crypti. And so it looks like... I don't know. I can't really judge it. Game credits, I don't know. Gulden is interesting. It's a cryptocurrency in the Netherlands, and they are really focused on mass adoption and user friendliness. That's very good. But to my knowledge, they also don't have a business model. And everything you can do with Gulden, you can also do with Bitcoin. So it's a copy coin, but it's branded very smartly. But it just has gone up from 1 million to 10 million. I think actually it's worth to take a gamble, this one. If you want to invest in altcoins, this could be in it also. BitShares, that's made by the same people that also have done Steam now. That's a big problem in cryptocurrency world. People, they start something, founders, and then they move on to another project. NXT also suffers from that. It sucks, really. For that reason, I would not invest in BitShares, because the founder has moved on to another project. Ardor is NXT. The follow-up is Ardor. NXT still exists, but the developer has launched a new blockchain and has given all NXT holders also Ardor. And so that's interesting. It's a big investment of me. But it has changed. Like, this is not even online yet. It's the testnet is going to be soon released, and so the risk of this coin is much higher than an established coin that's working. But of course, it's all based on NXT, and NXT has a great track record in working for 3 years, even though it's 100% proof of stake, and it's very difficult to understand. So a lot of people from Bitcoin world, they say that that's not secure, but there has not been a 51% attack, not even close. So it has been working well, and Ardor may have a future. It's valued 10 million. I think it's worth to invest a little in as part of a cryptocurrency portfolio, of an altcoin portfolio, yes. Xorum, I don't know. Zcash is also worth only 10 million. Watch my other videos about NXT Ardor. I made a lot of that. Zcash is very interesting. It's a new kit on the block, anonymity coin, but it doesn't mix transactions automatically. But it also has a business model, but only for 4 years, then it stops, and they won't pay the developers anymore, the marketing team. I don't understand how these people come up with these models, when you clearly see it's not sustainable. But yeah, 4 years is a long time. I think at the current valuation of 10 million is low, and it could go a lot higher. So I think it does deserve a piece in a cryptocurrency portfolio. Shadow Cash is 10 million. And even though Zcash has massive inflation, so the market cap is 10 million, but of course every day a lot of new coins. So the market cap, even if the price stays the same, the market cap will go up at current rhythm to like a few hundred million in 1 year time. So actually that's more like the fair market cap, because you have such high inflation. It's actually not a 10 million coin. It's more like a 100 million coin. And at that valuation, I'm not so sure. I think then it becomes more risky. A Shadow Cash is worth 8 million. And that is an interesting coin, because it's a proof of stake coin, and it is private. It offers privacy. I don't know if they mix transaction standard, but it's very interesting. The only proof of stake coin, to my knowledge, that also focused on privacy. And they also have they are building a decentralized marketplace. I think it's an interesting project, but I don't understand the philosophy behind it, because they want to focus on white markets, not offer black markets and black goods a chance. But to me, like, it's logical that the first decentralized marketplace will gain traction in the black market, of course, because that's where it's really needed. For the same reason, Bitcoin found its first real use in the black market on the internet. The same will be true for a decentralized marketplace. The first successful one will be a black market. So I don't understand. And they are also totally visible, these developers. So I don't understand how they are, like, how they think that a decentralized marketplace will take off with goods that you can buy on eBay or Amazon. That's just not gonna work out. So I would not invest in it due to that. Emmercoin, I don't know. Storycoin, I don't know. Bitcoin is a competitor of Monero, I think. Might be worth investing a little in, but I haven't really studied it. Golem Network, I don't know. Tether, I don't know. Kilocoin, I don't know. Antshares is a new coin, but I don't know enough to invest. Stratis, new coin. These are the same objectives as NXT. Stratis, they or Ardor, they are like offer blockchain services, or Ethereum, but Stratis is really focused on businesses. So I don't know if that's a worthwhile investment. I've watched some interviews with the founder, and I don't have a feeling. I trust this guy. I like this guy, and I really like to have that when I invest in something. But that's very subjective, so I can't really judge that. And then there is NXT, a big investment of mine. I think it's worth a bet, certainly at these valuations. However, NXT, it has lost its developer, and its developers are going, and its marketing team, so Jean-Luc, Ricker, Bas, Dave, they move on to Ardor. And of course they are saying, like, yeah, NXT has a future, but in my book, a coin needs developers. I've learned that the hard way, thinking that no, the coin is stronger than the developer. No, that's not the case. For Bitcoin, that's the case, but not for startups. Startups are fully dependent on developer, and if the developer says bye-bye, well, you can say goodbye to your project too. So NXT, I personally don't think has a big future, but NXT will still be used for the issuance of another token. It has, Ardor was based on how much NXT you have, but the Ardor is the mother chain, the child chain is Ignis, that still has to be released, and that will also be based on how much NXT you have. And so they need to, like, this coin you need actually to be part of the Ardor project. So for that reason, I think it's certainly a good bet to take. And then you have BitCrystals, I don't know. Peercoin, the old Peercoin, still there, 5 million market cap, but very little innovations. But it was the first proof of stake coin, but I wouldn't invest. Counterparty is actually, might be interesting, but it's the same problem as with Waves. You can trade on the counterparty, it's a decentralized asset exchange, but it's built on Bitcoin. You can trade assets there, but you don't need the counterparty coin, you can do it with Bitcoin. So I don't understand the business model, and therefore I wouldn't invest in it. But this is very superficial of me. A lot of my comments are wrong. If you dig just a little bit in a project, you will likely discover that. So you have to go with your gut feeling, do what you like, and then do some more study. Singular, DTV, I don't know. Syscoin, I don't know. Agoras tokens, I don't know. IOCoin, I don't know. Siacoin, I don't know. Bitcoin Dark, not Rubycoin. Scenario. This, I think, is a project that's 4 million. It has corrected strongly. I've talked about in previous videos. I think it's not going to work out with this project, but it has corrected strongly, so you could take a short-term bet on this. I don't think it will work out, because the amount of new coins issued is tremendous. I have to pay for everything. They issue new coins. They're, and the goals are way too ambitious to be the next Facebook, decentralized Facebook. IBCoin, I will just start to only name the ones that I have anything to say about. IBCoin, not Navcoin, not Global Currency, not Namecoin. It's an old project, like Dogecoin and Litecoin, so I wouldn't invest in that because it's basically a dead project to my knowledge. Safe Exchange, Solarcoin, Blackcoin used to be a big boy. Corrected a lot, only worth 2 million. but I don't know enough about the project to judge. It is a proof of stake coin, but I don't know anything more about it. Highcoin, Potcoin, Lomocoin, Digibyte, Around, Supernet. It's a project of James. I think it's way too risky to invest in that. It's not a coin even. Omni is another interesting project, valued $1.5 million. It's actually the follow-up of MasterCoin. MasterCoin, the first big altcoin that did a crowdfunding, was MasterCoin in 2012 or 2012, I think. But like Ethereum, they blew all the money. But it was worse than that. After that, the project totally collapsed. But if you look at the results they have totally rebranded themselves. They were worth once upon a time 100 million, they're worth 1 million now. But this one, they have, this is a decentralized asset exchange. And so they are the most successful one in the Bitcoin world. If you look at the amount of assets traded there and the market caps they have, it's actually, they have great results. But what I don't understand is the coin situation again. Like, do you need the coins? For what do you need the coins? Can you do everything with Bitcoin? Yeah, why would you then, why would Omni go up in value? That I don't know. Gridcoin, I don't know. Clams is another coin I invested in. It's a proof of stake coin. It's very interesting. I like that, 100% proof of stake. But it also has a utility you need it to invest or to gamble on just dice they made some poor decisions, like many coins. This one distributed a lot of free coins to a lot of people, and of course that does not create value. That's really a big misconception in the cryptocurrency world, because most of these people, they don't care about the coin. Free coins, great, give it to me and I will sell them. And so you see that a lot in these projects that's happening. And so Clams has that weakness too. But with Clams, it's that the people will only like find them if the price goes up, because they have to dig them up. They have to look at their old addresses, old Bitcoin, Dogecoin and Litecoin addresses. All of them got some free Clams. So only when the price goes up, you see that new coins come onto the market. So before that, you have a chance to sell some Clams at profit. Voila, Clams is 0.63, and I think I'm gonna leave it at that. So guys, in summary, while the whole world starts to, or the crypto world is focusing on Bitcoin, hoping it's going to hit $1,000 soon, they are ignoring altcoins, and the buying opportunity is there right now, and there is a very, very high chance that once Bitcoin breaks $1,000, that these altcoins will start to go up a lot more than Bitcoin. I always thought and mentioned in previous videos that I thought this was because of diversification of Bitcoiners into altcoins, but I forgot one important reason is also newcomers, the masses. Many of them with an opportunistic mindset come in and say, yeah, okay, Bitcoin, but it already went up a lot. Maybe I can make equally large gains if I buy an altcoin. I think that's also one of the big reasons why these altcoins start to go up a lot more than Bitcoin, because they come from much smaller market capitalization, so they are pumped much easier. And so the combination of Bitcoiners diversifying and newcomers also putting in some money into altcoins, and actually maybe they put only like 20 or 30% into altcoins and 70% in Bitcoin, or 50-50, but that means that because the market cap in cryptocurrency world is 80% Bitcoin and only 20% altcoins. So if they like on average put in 50-50, you see that or even 70-30, there actually goes in a lot more capital into altcoins than in Bitcoin, and so it's pumped a lot higher, and so it's not really that much related to fundamentals of altcoins. What you saw in previous bubbles is that even shitcoins go up a lot more than Bitcoin. So that's why I think right now the opportunity is in altcoins much more than in Bitcoin. And if you are able to take on larger risk, because of course altcoins are much larger risk than Bitcoin, then you may well be highly rewarded for that in the short term if we get another Bitcoin bubble. But I like to, as the famous investor Warren Buffett and his master Graham teached in the book Security Analysis, to have always a margin of safety. Don't buy at fair value, only buy below fair value, so that you have a margin of safety. And so that means in altcoins that I won't buy shitcoins, because there is a small chance that we don't get a Bitcoin bubble, but that actually Bitcoin goes into a bear market again. Due to the highest risk right now is, of course, the fundamentals of Bitcoin long term have weakened a lot. Transactions have peaked out, and so you can't go up anymore in amount of transactions currently due to the software not or the block size limit not being increased. They have other solutions to scale Bitcoin, but it's Lightning Network and all that, and it may not happen if there is continues to be internal war in Bitcoin. So this may actually cause a bear market instead of a new bubble. And so in that case, it may well be that only quality coins, coins that have innovated versus Bitcoin and provide solutions for the problems Bitcoin has, may be the only ones that do well or preserve their value the best. And while in the meantime, shitcoins go to zero, because in a bear market, it will be very difficult for Bitcoin and even for altcoins, quality altcoins. So the highest risk there is then, of course, altcoins with low, not good fundamentals. So that's why the biggest problems of Bitcoin today is scalability. It's not scaling. So altcoins that provide a solution there, or building a believable solution, may really go up a lot in value. And those are, to my knowledge, Ardor. So the follow-up of NXT, Ardor, is really a new design of NXT, but that is much more scalable. Other coins that are more scalable, I think, are coins. Is also, I think, IOTA, actually made by come from Beyond and David, who used to be the lead developer in NXT, come from Beyond, has moved on to this new project, IOTA. I haven't invested in that, but They do offer a very different solution to cryptocurrencies that is much more scalable. They basically drop the transaction history and only keep the end balance. And so each node or wallet does not have a blockchain, a long blockchain with a complete transaction history. No, they only keep the end balance. And so that is much more scalable. But it also loses trust by, well, would you trust a cryptocurrency where the nodes don't have the full history of all transactions? There is a higher risk there that if somebody steals coins or there is inflation, that you can't trace back where the fraud or theft or origins. So there is, it may not catch on, but it is a scalable solution. So, and other problems in Bitcoin is privacy. It is a real hassle to keep your privacy. It requires a lot of work, and Monero has offered a solution to that. Is the leader there, and so may go up a lot also, even in a Bitcoin bear market. Is the leader in the privacy segment. But I think other quality coins with good fundamentals are Ethereum, which is not really a cryptocurrency, but a crypto platform, and they may also succeed big. Independent, even in a Bitcoin bear market, Ethereum may go up a lot if indeed some successful decentralized applications are built on top of it that catch on. Then Ether may go up a lot in value too. And I think Dash, it does solve some of the fundamental problems of Bitcoin, which is that I think the internal war for a big part is caused by the developers not being paid by Bitcoiners. And it's all based on donations, and that doesn't work very well. So they are frustrated. They need another source of income. And that's why I think they are not scaling on the blockchain, but they are like building another network on top of it, Lightning Network. And that way they can actually, via the transaction fees and the Blockstream company, make some money, which makes a lot of sense for them, of course, but it's a weakness of Bitcoin, and Dash solves that by paying the developers directly from the blockchain. So the newly issued coins go to not only the miners, but also mixers and also people that develop or market the coin. So even in a bear market, Dash may do well. And so does Ardor, I think, and NXT. And of course, there are a lot of other coins that also may do well that I don't have enough knowledge about and that I'm not seeing. But like, the coins I don't dare to invest in, even though they would probably do very well if we get a bull market in Bitcoin, is, for example, Dogecoin and even Litecoin, and also Golden. So these have, Dogecoin especially, has gone down a lot in value, but it may, if we get a new Bitcoin bubble, go up a lot in value again, because it has a strong brand, as mentioned before. And but the big risk there for me is if we don't get a Bitcoin bubble, we get a bear market, then Dogecoin may well die, because it doesn't really offer any solutions to the problems Bitcoin has. And the same is true for Litecoin. And so that's why I think good diversifications currently are from Bitcoin, or if you have fiat still to invest, well, you know, Ethereum, it has been going down. It's half the value it was half a year ago. And it's very likely going to correct some more. So you can put buy walls there. And buy it relatively cheaply, but it's still the most expensive coin, so I wouldn't like invest a lot in it, but some. And then Monero, it's a pity, it just has gone up a lot too, but it has also halved again in value, and so you can also pick up some coins there. And the same for Dash. Actually, Dash hasn't gone up a lot yet, but these three coins the past 2-3 years have gone up a lot, times 10, all three of them. So it's not like a steal, but compared to Bitcoin, it may well be a steal. It's all compared to what? Huh? And so it may go up a lot more than Bitcoin. If there's a bubble, it may go up a lot more, but if there's a bear market, that it also may go up a lot more. And of course, I'm you have to be careful with my advice, because I'm biased. I have invested in NXT Ardor, so of course I'm also like think that's a good investment, but I'm very biased, huh? Because I have invested. But for me, that's one of the coins that is still extremely low valued. It has its problems. All coins have their problems. Ethereum has problems. Monero has problems. Dash has problems. And so does Ardor and NXT. But the valuation of Ardor and NXT is like 15 million. It's like 10 times cheaper than Dash or Monero. And in the long term, it still has a chance to actually become more valuable. But of course, it's much higher risk than Bitcoin, all of these coins. So voila, that's it. I hope you all have a great day, and thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. I think we're reaching 1,000 subscribers. That's really cool. And please share my video if you like it. That really helps me to reach more people. Good luck, guys. Bye.